to the Fit and Healthy Today show. Today, our subject matter will be acne, a most very common problem between ages between 12 and 40s, particularly for adolescents and premenopausal women. 80% of people between those ages suffer from some form of mild, moderate, or heavy acne. So heavy subject matter here. I'm going to try and get through as much information as I possibly can in the time that I have. First of all, acne, we have these little glands under our skin that produce something called sebum, or sebum. And what it is it keeps the skin moist. It's an oil gland. What happens is certain things can cause an increase in production of the sebum and cause little areas to get clogged under the pores, bacterias, and form either blackheads, which is a mixture with something called keratin under the skin and various skin pigments, or actually get inflamed and become slightly infected. So we're going to give you some suggestions today. We're going to define it, give you some suggestions as far as diet is concerned, and then the supplementation you can do to help alleviate the symptoms of acne. First of all, hormonal fluctuations or imbalance are probably one of the biggest causes of premenopausal and adolescent acne, which primarily arises from androgens, the conversion of testosterone into dehydrotestosterone, and then estrogens are somewhat antagonistic, particularly environmental estrogens. In a nutshell, hormones are fluctuating all over the place, and it causes acne and the sebum to overproduce. Poor diet, poor digestion. You don't break down fats, you have the wrong kinds of foods, you take in toxic chemicals, over 3,000 different toxic chemicals in the U.S. added to food, will cause your liver to become toxic. Your cellular, on a cellular level, you become toxic. You're not digesting your foods. The liver becomes imbalanced. You just cannot properly regulate your hormones or stabilize the hormones. Emotional distress, increases in cortisol cause hormones to become disrupted. And cortisol releasing causes kind of like a battery acid on the vascular system, so it decreases circulation. Nutritional deficiencies. In order to maintain healthy skin, healthy bacterial levels in the skin, and the proper sebum content in the skin, certain nutrients are required to maintain health in that regard. Food sensitivities or chemical exposures. So if you get chemicals or you have certain types of allergies, allergies make you inflamed and hypersensitive, and so it'll make the skin inflamed and hypersensitive to everything, and therefore you'll get that acne breakout. Chemical exposure, particularly with those 3,000 chemicals that I mentioned, along with all the pesticide chemicals, all the other clinging chemicals that we're exposed to, your body has to detox all of these. I heard an estimation that my great-grandparents were exposed in a lifetime to chemicals of what we're exposed to in one day. Just a lot more chemicals than the old days, 100 years ago. Genetics can affect it, a propensity towards having more skin issues or having thinner skin or how your sebum regulates itself or how good your liver. Genetically, certain people, families who have problems with acne, their kids will have more problems, but we can reduce it with some of the other suggestions I'm going to give. Candida. The sugar feeds that candida, and with such high amounts of sugarholics, people who consume a lot of sugar, processed foods, it feeds something called candida, or otherwise aka known as yeast. And that yeast just goes crazy. It causes you to become inflamed, hypersensitive, and actually, literally, they have done testings on the skin as far as the glucose is concerned when people have diabetes or high sugar content, and literally how the skin and the cells process sugar comes out definitely through the skin. We're going to address diet first of all, and the things that you can do dietary to help, and then the things that you can avoid that hinder the process or contribute to acne. Diets, and good old Jack Lane 40 years ago said, diets of unprocessed foods. Good old wholesome shopping the perimeter of the grocery store. A lot of fruits and vegetables. Good sources of quality protein. Now, mind you, hormone-free protein, because guess what? Most of the meats we find standardly in grocery stores are full of growth hormone, steroids, which also cause breakouts, and other chemicals that they inject, dyes and everything else. So finding good clean sources of meat or vegetable sources of protein like beans, cheeses, certain things like that are going to be much less likely to have those growth hormones, provided that they are hormone-free, and you have to look for that. Dark green and orange vegetables, the carotenoids and then the green vegetables. And then there are certain foods that contain an acid called oxalic acid, which includes almonds, beets, cashews, and Swiss chard, we call it. And those acids really can help reduce breakouts, bottom line. So eating those types of foods, which most of us like other than Swiss chard, it's kind of oof. But you can add vinegar and things to it. But generally, those other types of things, we like almonds and beets and that type of stuff, really helps with acne. A quarter cup of ground flax seeds or at least 35 grams of fruit or vegetable fiber. If you don't have adequate amounts of fiber in the diet, you can't detox. You can't rid the bowel of the toxins. And the longer your toxins stay in the bowel, the more they get reabsorbed back into the body and make you toxic all over again. Nuts and seeds like almonds and walnuts, ones that you're not allergic to. Good fats, what we call good fats in the diet, almonds, walnuts, pecans, sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, avocados, they reduce inflammation. And they can help also stabilize those hormones that we discussed earlier to help reduce acne symptoms. We talked about quality protein, making sure and doing your best to make it more vegetable sources of protein or organic sources. Lots of water. So, you know, they tell you 8 glasses a day. So that means an 8-ounce glass of water about every 2 hours. And obviously, you got to adjust that accordingly, because if we do one right before we go to bed, we're going to be up in the middle of the night. So you need more of your water in your earlier parts of your day, but a minimum of a glass of water every 2 hours. So carrying that water bottle along. Water cleanses the cells. It detoxes. It moves bowel along. It's one of the key detoxifying agents. And so many people are drinking sodas and coffee and things like that, that they're not washing and cleaning out the cells. Active live bacteria yogurt. There's things like Daneva and other. Most of those only contain just a few strains of bacteria, but they can be helpful in building up some of that bacteria levels in the bowel that can help you fight off those staph infections with those little white breakouts. Foods to avoid, and this I kind of really want to focus on, especially among the kids and the sugarholics. You gotta avoid junk and processed foods as much as you can if you have acne issues. I mean, this is junk. They're full of hydrogenated oils and fats. Fats that literally are chemical. They don't break down. They're called trans fats. And some actually governments and city governments have outlawed them. Sugar encourages oil production and bacteria or yeast. And remember how I told you how they actually literally tested the skin? There literally is something called skin diabetes, which basically means you have these cells in your skin that hold a lot more sugar and much more sugar receptive. And under those circumstances, guess what? Sugar feeds bacteria and yeast, so you're going to break out more. So getting yourself off of that sugar to change those cells and how they receive sugars is very, very important. Food allergies, particularly to dairy, wheat, corn, chocolate, those tend to be some of the worst offenders, other than hydrogenated foods, to contribute towards acne. So if you can avoid those for a while to see whether or not your body responds or reacts or eliminate them and maybe add one at a time and see if it aggravates your acne, very good option to choose. Obviously, acne isn't just a physical thing. It affects people emotionally, especially kids. People make fun, all those kinds of things. As an adult, you can usually deal with it a little bit better. But kids are sensitive to their peer pressure. And